You don't need to refresh all your data if only your recent data changed. What you require is using incremental refresh in Power BI. Hello everyone, Shab is back with another interesting video. Previously, I created a video about incremental refresh in Power BI, and I received many comments and questions about it. Today, I'm going to talk about incremental refresh in Power BI with some new additional points. So, if it's the first time you're watching my videos, don't forget to hit the subscribe button to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. Stay tuned. First, let's see what incremental refresh is. Incremental refresh in Power BI is a feature that allows you to update only a portion of your dataset, instead of refreshing the entire dataset every time new data is added. This is particularly useful when dealing with large datasets that don't change entirely, as it can significantly reduce the refresh time and improve performance. When you set up an incremental refresh, Power BI keeps track of the last refresh and only pulls in new or modified data since that last refresh. This approach is much more efficient compared to refreshing the entire dataset, especially in scenarios where the dataset is too large to refresh quickly. But there are some requirements to use incremental refresh in Power BI. First, you need to have a Power BI Pro or Premium license. So, this option is not available for free licenses. Next, your data sources should support query folding. Query folding is a crucial concept in Power BI and other data transformation tools that helps improve the efficiency and performance of data retrieval from external data sources. When you connect to an external data source, for example, a database, web service, or API, and perform data transformation in Power Query Editor, the goal of query folding is to push as much of the data manipulation logic back to the data source itself, rather than performing it in Power BI. How you can see query folding is enabled is checking from these steps. If you right-click on this step, you can see an option, View Native Query. If it's grayed out, it means query folding is not available on your table. Sometimes, even if you use a SQL-based database, you will find out this option is not available for you. And there are some solutions to tackle this issue. If you're interested, you can watch these two videos to learn more. Consider we have this report, and it gets data from sources which supports query folding. To start, I click on Transform Data and open Power Query Editor window. For example, I want to apply incremental refresh on my fact sales table. As you can see, if I right-click on this last step, View Native Query is available. And by choosing it, you can see the SQL query behind this table. My license is also supporting incremental refresh, and so now I can use this feature. To begin with, we need to have a date time column in our table, which is being used as the column for conducting incremental refresh. In our example, we will observe that the date key column in our fact sales table functions as a date time column employed for this intention. Next, we need to create two parameters. So, from the Home tab and Parameter section, I choose Manage Parameters. Then I click on New to create the first parameter. Name it as Range Start. Choose the type as Datetime and insert any value you like. For example, 1st of August 2023. It doesn't matter what value you choose for it. Now we can create the next parameter the same as the first one. I call it as RangeEnd and then choose a Datetime type and a date value. When I press on OK, you can see these two parameters created for you. You can easily change their values by clicking on each of them and change their values. But for now, we don't need to do that. What we need to do is on our date time column in the fact table, click on this chevron and choose date filters. And from the options, choose custom filters. Here I need to choose the date is after or equal to, and then in the next field, choose the range start parameter created earlier. And in the next field, select before our other parameter range end. By applying this filter, you can see our fact table filtered for the range defined. Don't worry if you can't see the values you like. You can easily change the range start and range end parameter values to whatever you like to change the filter on fact. But in case of incremental refresh, we don't need to apply any changes. I just click on close and apply to go back to the report. To set up incremental refresh, the last step remains. I right-click on the fact table and choose incremental refresh option, and then you can see this new window. In this page, first you can choose the table you want to apply the incremental refresh on it. Then turn on the toggle for incrementally refresh on this table, and some options will appear for you. First, you need to define the length of time you need to keep historic data in your dataset. For example, I choose 2 years here. Then we need to choose the period for incremental refresh. For example, here I choose 2 months. So what happens after refreshing the dataset is it keeps the last 2 years data with only 2 months refresh. It means only the last 2 months of our data will be refreshed and the rest will remain as it is. You can see all this information described here for you. These were the essential settings for incremental refresh. However, there are a few other options available for you here. The first option is to enable getting the latest data with direct query, and this option is only available for premium users. If you check the second option, it only refreshes when the month is completed. Sometimes you need to get data only when a month is completed, and in this case, you will select this option. And the last one helps you to detect which rows of data have changed. And below here, you can see all the policies you applied. At the end, I need to press on apply. Now, whenever you publish your report and refresh it, the last 2 years of data will be kept with the last 2 months refresh option. It's how you can easily set the incremental refresh on your report. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like and share it and subscribe to the channel to get the notification for the new upcoming videos. Have a good day, all Power BI done.